SA701. Communicating key audit matters in the independent auditor's report. In the independent audit report, you know, communicating deals as per SA 260, communication is required with the those charged with the governance or management. So certain issues are communicated, correct? Out of these issues, which are material, is taken into consideration. Out of this, key or a significant are dealt in the SA 701. Communicating key audit matters. So we have in this purpose, what is the purpose for this SA 701, what is the scope, what are all applicable and what is not applicable, determining the key audit matters, KAM, how to determine the key audit matters, what are the key audit matters, how we can identify. Last one is communicating. So four parts are there. First part is purpose, second scope, third part is determining key audit matters, fourth part is communicating. These are very important. What is the purpose? What do you think? Why SA 701 is required? Purpose for the greater transparency of the audit. First one, of course, communication. Purpose is first. Value of communication, communication value, that is very very basic. If you go under purpose, communication value, and also greater transparency of the audit, of the audit work. Auditor can say, see, this is what I audited, this is what, as per my professional sound judgment, this is the significant matters, significant. So these are the purpose. So point number one is SA 701 provide guidance regarding the communication of key audit matters. Key audit matters are those matters in the auditor's professional judgment where most significance in the audit of the financial statements of the current period. Key audit matters are selected from the matters communicated with those charged with the governance. So basic, you have to understand what is key audit matter. Yes, it is a matter, but what kind of matter? As per auditor's judgment, professional judgment, it is a significant matters. So according to the auditor, these matters are significant on the of the audit of the financial statement. This is the key audit matter. So these key audit matter has to be communicated. Purpose: the purpose of communicating key audit matters is to enhance the communicative value of auditor's report by providing greater transparency about the audit that was performed. So what is the purpose? Again, of course, basic function, communicative value. Purpose of the SA-701, and also it shows greater transparency of the audit performed by the auditor. Communicating key audit matters provides additional information to intended users, not for the all users, intended users, users of the financial statements, intended users, to assist them in understanding those matters that in the auditor's professional judgment were most significant in the audit of the financial statement. That is again the meaning of the key audit matter of the current period. Again, this is with regard to the current period. Communicating key audit matters may also assist intended users in understanding the entity and areas of significant management judgment in the audit of the financial statements. So one more purpose is it provides additional information to intended, so it is a subjective user. And the point to be noted, of the current period, example Mr. A 2018-19 auditor, he found out key audit matter but he didn't mention, didn't follow the SA-701 in this year. He is a auditor X company. He prepared key opinion as per SA-701. This is not opinion, okay? Key audit matter is not opinion. It is just additional information in the report. So these key audit matters are there, but he did not include it as per SA-701 in the 2018-19. But Mr. A, during 2019-20, he wanted to include this key audit matter in this report of the 2019-20. He cannot do so because it says of the current period. So this is possible in the MCQ. Again, in the audit of the financial statement of the current period. Next one, scope. We will move on to scope. Communicating key audit matters in the auditor's report is in the context of the auditor having performed an opinion on the financial statements as a whole. Communicating key audit matters in the auditor report is not. So the first of all is communicating this key audit matters should be on whole What do you mean by that? Financial statement should be looked as a whole. Total. Total, not a particular figure. Total should be considered whole. Certain part of the transactions or events cannot be considered. Again, this is may ask in MCQ possible questions. So score, first of all, it cannot be part, it should be of the whole. Again, what is that? Communicating key audit matters in the auditor's report in the context of the auditor having performed an opinion on the financial statement as a whole. So opinion should be as on the whole of the financial statement. So what and all not included? Communicating key audit matters in auditor's report is not, so this is not a key audit matters, a substitute for disclosure in the financial statements that the applicable financial reporting framework requires management to make or that are otherwise necessary to achieve fair presentation. So it cannot be substitute for. So key audit it cannot be substitute for what? Disclosures in the financial statement that the applicable financial reporting framework requires management to make. So who has to make? What is that? Applicable financial reporting framework, FRF, applicable financial reporting. So these applicable financial reporting framework requires to make by the management. So this is so these key audit matter is not substitute for this. So this is also not substitute for the modified opinion 705, correct? If auditor found out that there is a modified opinion is required, modified opinion is required in the audit report, so he cannot issue only key audit matters, so excluding the modified report. So this is wrong. He has to issue modified report, that is unqualified or adverse or disclaimer of opinion. Key audit matter is not substitute for SA 705. So it is not a substitute for the auditor expressing a modified opinion when required by the circumstances based on the audit evidence done by performed by the auditor. So according to the SA 705, it cannot be substitute. So it also cannot be substitute for the SA 570 going concern. When a material uncertainty involves in the going concern, auditor cannot issue only key audit matter excluding mentioning separate opinion with regard to going concern. So it cannot be substitute. So reporting in accordance with the SS 570 when a material uncertainty exists relating to any events or a condition that may cast significant doubt on entity's ability to continue as a going concern. This may you heard in various topics in law also. What is that? Events or condition that may cast significant doubt on entity's ability to continue as a going concern. So it cannot be substituted for that. Key audit matter cannot be substituted. So last one, a separate opinion on the individual matter. If there is an individual matter, it cannot be substituted. It will be considered only as a whole. So these are the scope. It cannot be substituted for the disclosure in the financial statement that the applicable FRF, applicable financial reporting framework, requires management to make all that are otherwise necessary to achieve fair representation. It is not a substitute for the auditor. It is not. Auditor report is not communicating key audit matters in the auditor's report is not a substitute for the auditor expressing a modified opinion when required by the circumstances of a specific audit engagement in accordance with the SA 705. That is a modified opinion. It is not a substitute for reporting in accordance with the SS 570. When a material uncertainty exists relating to events or condition that may cast significant doubt on the entity's ability to continue as a going concern, that is 3 points. Fourth point, a separate opinion on individual matters. Now this SA applies to audit of complete set of general purpose financial statement of listed entities. That you know, circumstances when the auditor otherwise decides to communicate key audit matters in the audit report. This SA also applies when an auditor is required by law or a regulation to communicate key audit matters in the auditor's report. However, SA 705 prohibits the auditor from communicating the key audit matters when the auditor disclaims an opinion on the financial statements unless such reporting is required by law or regulation. So this may possible in MCQ. So usual rule is that in case modified opinion is there, key audit matter, communication of key audit matter is not enough. It is not required. It is not a substitute. But as per law or regulation, says key audit matters should include the modified opinion, that disclaimer or adverse, this should include in key audit matter, then it can. This is a exception. So when law says or regulation says, it can be. So it is a again MCQ possible question. This SA also applies when auditor is required by law or regulation to communicate key audit matters in the auditor's report. However, SA 705, that is a modified opinion, prohibits the auditor from communicating the key audit matters when the auditor disclaims an opinion on the financial statements unless such reporting is required by law or regulation. So the word is prohibition, very important. Third point is determining the key audit matters. What is the audit matters? Very important. Examination point of view, very important. So determining the key audit matters. So first of all, who has to determine? Of course, auditor. So auditor will determine from what. So there are matters, lots of matters will be there, no? From the audit, you got so many matters. Out of those matters, you have to select which are key audit matters or significant matters. So when matters communicated with those charged with the governance, those matters that require significant auditor attention in performing the audit, that matter has to be determined. How to determine these matters? So we have three points. Point A, point B, point C. What do you think as a think like a auditor? You are a auditor of a XYZ Limited. You are doing the audit. You found out so many matters. Out of these matters, as a professional judgment, using the professional judgment, how you can select key audit matter that is a significant matters from these. So when there is a high risk of material misstatement or a significant risks are identified, that matters is a key matter, correct? Key audit matter, right? So area of high risk, I assessed risk. So significant risk is identified where we identify using SA 315, correct? So these matters are we can determine as a key audit matter. Then as per your judgment, what we can consider key audit matter? Areas in which financial statement that involved a significant management judgment. When there is a significant management judgment best example accounting estimation, because this estimation uncertain, correct? So estimation can be highly uncertain, so these estimation accounting estimation can be identified as a key audit matters. So C, third point, major effect on the audit of the significant events or transaction occur during the event. What is the event? Event is a result, transaction, particular transaction. Sale of goods rupees 5 crore, that is a transaction. Events from the sales and purchase of profit rupees 3 crore, that is an event. That is a very basic thing. Effect on the audit of the significant events or a transaction, these also whatever effect is there for on the audit of the significant events and transaction occur during the period, it also considers for the determining the key audit matters. So auditor shall determine from the matters communicated with those charged with the governance those matters that require significant auditor attention in performing the audit. In making this determination, the auditor shall take into account areas of as high here assessed risk of material misstatement or a significant risk identified in the accordance with the SA 315. B, significant auditor judgments relating to areas in financial statement that involved significant management judgment. Significant management judgment including accounting estimates that have been identified as having high estimation uncertainty. Last one, the effect on the audit of significant events or transaction that occur during that period. Last is communicating key audit matters, that is very summary, you can say summary. So fourth point, last fourth main point, communicating key audit matter. So how to communicate? You know what is the key audit matter? According to auditor's professional judgment, that the most significance in the audit of the financial statement, that has to be mentioned. According to the auditor's professional judgment, where the most significant in the audit of the financial statements, very important, of the current period. One more thing is, these matters were addressed in the context of the audit of the financial statement as a whole, not as a part, and in forming the auditor's opinion thereon, and the auditor does not provide a separate opinion on these matters. So there is a no separate opinion. There is no separate opinion. So communicating key audit matters, the introductory language in this section of the auditor's report shall state that key audit matters are those matters that in the auditor's professional judgment were of most significance in the audit of the financial statement of the current period, and these matters were addressed in the context of the audit of the financial statement as a whole, and informing the auditor's opinion thereon, the auditor does not provide a separate opinion on these matters. Illustration is there. The following illustrate the presentation in the auditor's report. If the auditor has determined there are no key audit matters to communicate, so this example says there is no key audit matters to communicate. So except for the matter described in the basis for qualified opinion or section, material uncertainty related to going concern section, this is a separate to the key audit matter, we have determined that there are no other key audit matters to communicate in our report. So this will not be considered as a key audit matter. So we have to mention, we have determined that there are no other key audit matters to communicate in our report. So we seen all the parts, elements of the SAS 701, communicating key audit matters. What is a key audit matter? What is the purpose of the key SAS 701? Scope, determining the key audit matter, and how to communicate. So what is the purpose? Communicating value, greater transparency of the audit, significant matters, what is the matter, auditors, as per the auditor's professional judgment, significant, most significant of the audit of the financial statement, and the additional information to intended users. So it of the current period, it cannot be prior period. Then the scope, so as a whole should be considered, not a part. Then it cannot be substituted for the applicable FRF, cannot be substitute for the SA 705, adverse opinion or disclaimer opinion, modified opinion, cannot be substituted for SA 570, going concern. It is not for an individual matter. So in case of law and regulation, there is an exception for that. Then determining the key audit matters, we have seen 3 points. What are the matters? Out of these matters, key audit matters are selected. How to select? Area of high risk, high assessed risk, most significant risk identified as per SA 315, significant management judgment, that is a accounting estimation, because that is highly uncertain, and the effect on audit of the significant events and transaction. Last one, communication, that is again basic. In report, auditor has to state, as per auditor's professional judgment, of most significant in the audit of the financial statement, then it is considered based on the whole of the financial statement of the opinion, not a separate. It cannot give or issue or a report separate opinion. under SA-701. Communicating key audit matters in the independent auditor's report. Thank you.